Down again. there's the green flag, and now we're waiting for the 5 second board, then the red light to turn on, and then the green to turn on, and we're away, and it's a very good start from Ricardo Patrese. And Ricardo Patrese and Michael Schumacher stay flooding into third, behind Nigel Mansell, and that's a very good start. Trying to go around the outside, two, three abreast here through that first corner. But it's Ricardo Patrese leading from Nigel Mansell.
And Ayrton Senna used all his reserve muscle to get past Michael Schumacher. He came undone. The outside of Schumacher. Schumacher a little bit cautious going into that first corner. I think the reason was Nigel was out caught unawares. But in fact, the red light came on and there was not the required 5 or 2 seconds between. Now look at Ayrton Senna coming up alongside Schumacher. Schumacher swirling a little bit, Senna squeezing him. Now Schumacher looking for ground or space, can't find it. Senna's there, not giving way. In the meantime, Patrese took the initiative and taking the lead. But here's the point of the race, I think it's going to be very interesting. Michael Schumacher, you can see him just behind Ayrton Senna. Schumacher beginning to close up on Senna, but Michael Schumacher, I think, will find Ayrton Senna a very tough competitor to pass. Schumacher's car has been quicker down the straight than Senna's car, but that's not going to mean that he's going to get past Senna easily.
I don't think anyone will get past Ayrton Senna easily. At the moment in third place, 4.6 seconds behind Nigel Mansell, who's the second behind Ricardo Patrese. If you look at the lap times, both the Williams are in the 121s and Michael Schumacher is in the 122s and all the rest is 123 or even slower.
Well, this is just in the settling down period of the race. All the tension of the start has evaporated. Now working to find success. Once he's shaking his hand, I'm glad to get Michael Schumacher past. Senna stuck his right hand up there for some reason, annoyed by something we can't see from the in-car camera.
We can see the speed he's going at them. John, this is 6th gear. If we can stay with Senna to see it go through a lap, because we haven't really had a full lap yet, have we?
Schumacher getting closer to him, and of course Schumacher dragging along John Alesi and Martin Brundle. A lazy gearbox. So it's wrong to say that Senna's holding back the speed pursuing cars, but now Schumacher right on the gearbox and the lazy. Ayrton Senna struggling the car, the unit of the tires has evaporated. Schumacher needs to be very careful because the lazy will snatch that fourth place off him before he has a chance to think about it. Behind you, your concentration, of course, mostly focused in front of you. Philip Martin's under looking at an 85th place. Well, it's going to be a little bit of a scenario here. These third, three, fifth place.
Oh, that's Mansell and Patrese way, way ahead of everybody else. And Ayrton Senna, but behind Senna is the trainer, Schumacher, Alesi, Brundle, and even Gianluigi Martini, who's not far behind. Back at Interlagos, where Ricardo Patrese sits, and it is 8 lap, and Michael Schumacher is passing Ayrton Senna. And I think Senna has a problem, John.
Well, Senna has a problem since the second lap, really. And I can see that Senna's trying to bring it back. Michael, shut that door. You let Senna have the opportunity to work to get past the guy. What are you doing? You left the door wide open for the drive straight through. Well, because of this fight, the gap between Ayrton Senna and Nigel Mansell and Ricardo Patrese is over 16 seconds after 8 laps. Michael Schumacher, we can see in third, then John Alesi, then we see Martin Brundle, Gianluigi Martini, and Carl Wendlinger in head to Mark. Well, that's a problem. Senna's got a problem. I think he's having gear change problems. Did you wouldn't suddenly gear accelerate like that. But he got us back into gear. And look at this, and let's watch it again. Schumacher, he's got Senna behind him. He wasn't using his mirrors. He should have just made the cross, peel off one side of the track, and locked in. Well, Michael Schumacher is certainly the star, the young and up-and-coming star. But he'll have to learn a little bit quicker than that, because people like Ayrton Senna will take every advantage they can. And that's one of those little subjectly lessons that you do learn from a world champion.
And another fastest race lap for Nigel Mansell, now down to a 120.604, a 6 tenths of a second behind teammate Ricardo Patrese, who's led this race from the start. He took the lead into that first corner and he's held it ever since. But another 15 laps to go. Roughly 15 laps to go to the first time stop of the year. And it is seen that Patrese and Mansell are lapping up. They will have lapped the entire field before the race is coming in, before the race is. And they are managing to hold everybody up. We've seen or something like 3.5 seconds a lap lower than the 2 million. Of course, the effect is that now, from 14 days up to